I'm Dr. Nirina, Associate Professor and in charge HOD of the Department of Gastroenterology, Andhra Medical College, Visakhapatnam. Today I was asked to speak a few words on gastroesophageal reflux disease, which is a very common disease we see in the practice. This can be defined as the reflux of acid into the esophagus. This can be defined as GERD. And clinically, the main symptoms are heartburn and acid regurgitation. So, these are the two main symptoms with which the patient presents. And the patient might not be having both the symptoms at once, but the most common symptom is acid regurgitation. It can be seen in almost 70% of the population, and 50 to 60% of the population can present with heartburn. And some of the patients might present with complications of the reflux disease, like chronic cough and then recurrent pneumonia. That means the patient has a complicated disease. And in children, this can just present as a vomiting and a failure to thrive. The most common risk factors for GERD are one is change in lifestyle and consuming heavy meals at bedtime, and then smoking, alcohol, and some drugs which can decrease the lower esophageal sphincter pressure. So these things can increase the amount of the disease. The most common diseases that can be associated are the sliding hyalacemia. It's almost, it can be seen in 30% of the patients. And usually patients who have sliding hyalacemia usually have symptoms of GERD, and they can have a very complicated disease also. And the basic mechanism which is explained today is that normally there are transient relaxations of the lower esophageal sphincter, but these transient esophageal pressure, sphincter pressure can be decreased in more number of times. So this leads to reflux of the acid into the esophagus. And the most common diagnostic point is symptom-based. It's a symptom-based diagnosis. Patients who come to us with heartburn or regurgitation, usually we diagnose as reflux disease. And endoscopy is done only to confirm the diagnosis, even after 2 weeks of empirical therapy, or the patient has come to you with some complications of the disease, like obstruction.